Hey, any fish? 12th of March, 2023. I do sincerely pray that you're all doing well. This bank collapse is signaling something huge to me, and it came upon me early in the morning on Friday when they released this fake 311,000 jobs that they created. Absolute bogus lie. I mean, it just is. But they had to put out the 311. So later that day, Friday, the Silicon Valley Bank collapses. Very large bank. This is going to affect things greatly depending on what levers are pulled. I personally believe that they're going to allow this collapse to commence. How quickly it goes is another question. But I firmly believe this is the opening salvo of the first 42 months of tribulation and will lead to the mark of the beast by like 2026. They will be forcing the mark of the beast. That will be the end of the first 3.5 years. This is just how I see it. Everybody's got their theories and this is just how I'm seeing it. And you got to understand some of this stuff. The Silver Gate Bank. That bank has actually been around since 1988. Very successful bank. But the Silver Gate is the interesting part of it. Number one, silver, which is money, at least for now. At some point, it will be worthless as well. But the silver is a big component in these next few years, in my view. And the Silver Gate, if you look into astronomy, Orion, the hunter, his hand in their world, you know, this is like astrology, astronomy, you know, they mix everything and just distort it. So people have a tendency to not look at the stars because they think they're getting into astrology, when in fact, the stars were put there by God for signs and for seasons and for days and for years and all these things. God made the stars, so we are to look at them. And like I said, the Silver Gate is in Orion the Hunter's hand. It's literally, to them, a gateway of the soul. Which brings me back to the Omicron with David Bowie and how they hunt the souls. There's so much we could get into, it's really ridiculous, but I just want to warn people that this, in my personal view, is signaling the beginning of the collapse and the beginning of tribulation. We may not know because our hindsight becomes much clearer, you know what I mean? And so we have the Silver Gate Bank, been in business since 1988, which happens to be the exact year that the Economist magazine posted their Phoenix with the burning money, proclaiming a new world currency. Now, they put it down as 2018, but, you know, they're not perfect, and they prove it that they're not perfect all the time. Only God is perfect. But nonetheless, I mean, that was 12,844 days ago, as of the 10th, which I thought was interesting because 4 and 4 are 8, the 88. The magazine came out in January of 88. Silvergate Bank has been around since 88. So there's a pattern going on here. A new world currency, which is also 422 months. The 42 months. That's what I see. The beginning of the 42 months. Silicon Valley Bank collapses in the middle of the day, right? They don't usually do that unless it's like a very, very serious situation. You know what I mean? They'll usually wait till the end of the day, at least. But it's interesting in my mind how I see this. Silicon, it's an element. It's on the elemental chart, right? It's number 14. Think about this. Number 14, it's a member of group 14 in the periodic table. Carbon is above it. Okay, just remember that. Carbon. We're going to zero carbon, right? Carbon's number is 6. So we can look at the carbon molecule as 666, which is the number of the beast, which is what I believe this will eventually work itself to after the collapse, after the introduction of the digital currencies, after a few billion people die. And oddly enough, silicon, its melting point is 1414 degrees. So you got atomic number 14, group 14, and it melts at 1414. That indicates the generations, and to me, it indicates the last generation. We are in the last of the last 14 generations. Three sets, just like in Matthew 1. From Abraham to David, from David to the carrying away, to Babylon, and from the carrying away to Jesus. Three 14s, which equal 42, the beginning of the 42 months. And money in the Bible, this is very interesting. The last use of it in the Old Testament is Micah 3:11. Okay? And it talks about how the priests do things for money and the prophets prophesy for money. And they say, no evil can come upon us. And it matches to this day for sure. And the last use of the word money in the Bible is in 1 Timothy 6:10. And everyone knows this verse. The love of money is the root of all evil. But have we ever truly looked at it? The love of money is the root. I got to look at you for this. It's the root of all evil. Think about that. The root, as in the root of the tree, of all evil. Okay? And the only time that Jesus openly expressed anger was because of the money changers in the temple. Right? Matthew 21:12. Right? Don't forget, Jesus was betrayed by Judas for money. Silver, to be exact, like Silvergate. Just telling you guys, the bankers' tables, the usury, the interest. Go through the scriptures under the subject of money, and you'll see all this stuff. When David says, let their tables, their banks, become a snare and a trap and a stumbling block. And that happens to be Romans 11:9. And he's directly quoting Psalm 69, verses 22 and 23. Think of it, you guys, the pattern, the 9/11 pattern, Psalm 23, Psalm 46, which just happened to be when Obama recited Psalm 46 on 9/11/2011 is exactly to the day, 4,200 days. Think about it, the 42 months commencing. This is just what I see, you guys. It's a real thing. It's really happening. I don't know how else to convey it other than to advise you to seek Jesus Christ first and foremost. Have you received him? Do you know the good news? Have you heard the gospel? You'll find it in 1 Corinthians 15, verses 1 through 4. Read it, understand it. Pray in the name of Jesus for understanding. He will reveal it to you. That's a guarantee. Okay? And again, you know, making videos lately, I just have to be specifically led. And I felt this morning that this needs to be shared. I'm not trying to edit any spectacular videos anymore. It's all out there, you guys. We are on the edge here. It is commencing. And you need to be right with Jesus Christ. I'm serious. I cannot be more serious. The deception we see rising through the deep fake AI. You know, I mean, you guys, if you don't have the discernment through the Holy Spirit of God, which you receive through belief in the gospel of Jesus, in belief in his atoning blood. It's the most important thing you can do right now. And this all, of course, points back to the synagogue of Satan. That's who's behind all of this, the money changers. From day one, that's what their MO has been. You know, and it just so happens on 3/10 that the Times of Israel puts up an article talking about the Jews in England, right? And how they were so good at handling money. But eventually, they were kicked out of England as well. I don't know how many countries they were kicked out of. But do you know why they were kicked out of these countries? You hear stories about the blood libel and all these other things, and I can't prove whether or not those are true. But what you can prove is true is their love of money. The love of money. Do you understand? The root of all evil. And that's what they do. They love money. And so much so that every country they've gone into, they usurp the governments, take control of the money systems over and over and over again. They did it. So they were expelled from England. They were expelled from Spain. They were expelled just all over the place. These are the synagogue of Satan, you guys, the money changers, the bankers. And this lever is about to be pulled. I think it's already been pulled. This will domino and eventually lead to the mark of the beast. You will not buy or sell without this mark. And what that turns out to be, we just don't know. We see things as we go along. The scales are removed. Things become clearer. Our hindsight becomes 20/20. You know what I mean? We're here to show you the present so that when these things do come to pass, you can look back in hindsight and say, oh my God, the Bible is true. David said, let their tables become a snare and a trap and a stumbling block. In Psalm 69:23, 9:11. Look, you guys, I don't know. All I'm trying to do is warn you. I don't know how long or how exactly this will roll out. I do sincerely and truly love each and every one of you. And I just pray that you are solid and at rest and at peace in Christ Jesus. He is our peace, the only peace in a world where there is no peace. So, that's all I got for you guys. God bless each and every one of you. Peace and grace to you. Many fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,